إنه ليس من أهلك. Oh my beloved Nuh alayka salam, he's not your family. إِنَّهُ عَمَلٌ غَيْرُ صَالِحٌ. Surely he became kafir because of his bad deeds. And that was the effect of the suhbat and the company. And on the other hand, we realize that a dog which remained in the suhbat and the company of Ashab Kahf, that became dignified, that its mention has been made in the Quran. And till today, even till the day of Qiyamah, that dog would be mentioned in our salats, in the mihrab of the masjids, in the khutbahs of the ulama and the khutaba. And people are even reading wazifas of the name of the dog of Ashab Kahf. Subhanallah, dearest Islamic brothers, this is the effect of the company of friends of Allah, that even a dirty or a filthy dog, impure dog, attains such great station that its mention has been made in the Quran and we are taking its name in our salats. Mufassirin ikram have mentioned a very interesting point, that some animals will enter Jannat in the form of human being. And amongst them is the dog of Ashab Kahf and the she camel of Hazrat Sahli alayhi salam and the donkey of Hazrat Isa alayhi salam and the she camel of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called Qaswa will enter paradise in the form of human being. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have said that example of a good company is like the shop of an attar. Attar is a person who sells perfumes. And when you enter the shop of attar, even if you do not buy any perfume or any ether, you will still get the fragrance and perfume. Alhamdulillah, the good news for us is that our Pir Murshid, our spiritual mentor, our leader, the founder of Dawat Islami, is our spiritual attar. And the name of his shop is Dawat Islami. And the product that he sells in his shop is Neki Ki Dawat, is Madani Qafilas, practicing upon Madani Inamat. And inshallah Azza wa Jal, if we do that, we will indeed get the spiritual fragrance and the perfume of this great master inshallah Azza wa Jal. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have said that example of a bad company is like sitting in the shop of a blacksmith, where there is an oven where the fire is burning. Even if you are not burnt in that fire, but the ash that flies from that fire would blacken your clothes and your face, so you are affected by it. And this is the example of a good company and a bad company. Therefore Allah Azza wa Jal have ordered us to get up from a bad company. فَلَا تَقْعُدْ بَعْدَ الذِّكْرَ مَعَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. After realization, after understanding that you have sat in the company of bad people, and bad people meant here that any person who does anything which is evil, or even if he holds evil beliefs, they all are included in that. We must also understand that the effect of a company is based on the power of that person in whose company you are sitting. Therefore, the effect of the company of a Nabi would be different, and the effect of a company of a Wali would be different. and the effect of the suhbat of ulama would be different. And the effect of the suhbat of Sayyidul Anbiya, our beloved master, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would be different. And it is recorded that there were people who came in the company of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, within seconds, within moments, they become ulama, they become arifin, they become great awliya of Allah Azza wa Jal, because the company of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so powerful. If you look at the coal, it is black in color, and if you touch it, it is cold. But when you put the very same coal in a fire, it changes its color, it becomes red. And it is no more cold, it is very hot, it can even burn. And it does the same function like the fire. And that tells us how powerful the effect of suhbat or the company is. And we must also understand that in this ayah kareema, where it is prohibited to be in the company of evil people, it means that we should not adopt their suhbat or company with love and with respect, or we should not be desiring to be with them. But in order to do the propagation, in order to refute the beliefs of evil people, then to sit in their company is ibadah and worship. If the ulama do not sit in the company of the evil people, who will rectify them and who will improve them? Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also sat with the evil people, but he changed them. Those who were evil, he made them good people. Those who were non-Muslims, non-believers, he made them Muslims. But this is for those who can affect other people, who are powerful, who are knowledgeable, who are powerful in their characters. And as far as the ordinary public is concerned, they are advised not to sit in the company of any evil person, because of their own weakness, they might be affected by them rather than affecting them. So similarly, if there is a business to be done with the evil people, or coincidentally we said maybe we traveling in the train, or we in aeroplane, or in the bus, that is beyond our power and we cannot control it. So for that person would not be committing any sin. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's suhbat and the suhbat of Salihin brings beautiful colors in the lives of the Muslims. And on that physical suhbat, when a person gets the physical suhbat of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then its ahkam, its rules are different. For example, those who had the opportunity to be in the company of the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with iman in physical form, they will be regarded as the sahabi. And those who had the physical company of the sahabi, they would be regarded as tabi'i. And those who had the physical company of the tabi'i, they would be regarded as tabi'a tabi'i. So therefore, if any Muslim sees beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the dream, or spiritually he is linked with our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he cannot be regarded as sahabi, because the rules of physical suhbat and company are different, and the rules of spiritual suhbat and company is different. So we understand a very important point from here, that we should always take the company of the good people. And alhamdulillah, Dawat-e-Islami is creating that environment, that there are hundreds and thousands of Muslims that have become good in the suhbat, in the company of Da'wat Islami.